another video on a roller coaster, theme park, sandbox type game, but I'm not on Roller Coaster Tycoon 3 today, as you can probably tell from the title. We're doing something a bit different today. Over the next few weeks, on maybe Friday, Saturday, I'm not sure. This is uploading on a Saturday, but I'm recording this on the Friday before. We're going to do Roller Coaster of the Week. Not Roller Coaster of the Week, sorry. That's on another channel for some reason. We're going to do Game of the Week. We're going to be trying out different games, the public series in the future, and I'm going to try and do it over the rest of the summer. It might just be for 3 or 4 weeks. I've got 3 games planned at the moment. But yeah, and we are going to do a series on it soon. I just need to get to know the game a bit more first, so I know what we do when we do start it. But yeah, welcome to Planet Coaster, which is a game currently under development. It's in alpha, but you can still get it. It is more expensive if you get it now, but yeah. Now, if you've seen my Twitter, then you may have seen a couple of tweets and stuff saying that I was getting this, so some of you might already know about this. Anyway, I'll leave a link to that in the description. And I'd also like to say sorry about the commentary on one of the Roller Coaster Tycoon videos. We obviously had some issues with the microphone that I didn't realise when I was recording. That means I was speaking, but it obviously wasn't coming through. But yeah, we should be back to normal now, I hope. Well, you guys will know, if you hear me saying this now, then the microphone obviously works. But anyway, I built a few roller coasters, as you can see. I've built more than if I was doing this as a proper park. This is the first park I've ever done. And I know it's not got theming or anything. This is me just testing the game out and starting to build stuff. So anyway, if we go forward, now you can go into an RCT freestyle view, but I thought this would just be nice. There's the entrance over that way. Oh, wrong way. Still getting a bit used to this camera. The controls are slightly different than RCT3 with the camera and stuff. There's our entrance there. So, let's go and have a look at some rides. So, I've got a little balloon ride down here. Not going to ride on this now. And you can probably tell already the graphics are so much better than RCT3. The game play itself, well, obviously this is an alpha, so we don't have funds yet, but what we do have, we've got a good amount, we've got a good variety of roller coasters. I obviously would like to see more in the future, more types of roller coasters. So we've not got as much as RCT3 yet, but quality of what we've got, I'd say, is better quality than if it was RCT3. And look at these stations. This is so realistic. The queue lines and stuff, much more realistic than RCT. You probably hear me say about the graphics a lot in this video, because of how good they are. See, if you look at the station, this looks like a proper station. The only thing that I think looks a bit weird is, I'm trying to find it now, where is it? There's these like ticket booth things. Like, what is that supposed to? I know it's a ticket booth, but it just looks ugly. I'm not quite sure why it's there. I think it'd be better if that was sort of like, it'd be better like an entrance, like designing your own entrance. And what I might do with some of my rides is you can build, I'll try and build over that and basically sort of like an entrance or something with what the ride is. I might not be able to, but I'm certainly going to give it a go, because I'm not too happy about that, to be honest. You never know, they might change in the future. Yeah. Anyway, enough of me talking, let's go on some rides. Is it just left the station or not? So to ride it similar to RC3, we have that available. And it's going up the lift hill, that was perfect timing. And look at that lift hill, that's so realistic. I really am impressed with this game. Even though it's only in alpha, I can still tell that this is going to be really successful. This is the way forward with games like this. So, as you can probably hear, the people scream like in RC2, but they're a bit less like cartoon sort of screams. And as you can tell, look how smooth this is. There's no like thing in RC3, you can choose from like two types of three at the most, gradient and slope. This you can have any steepness you want. And yeah, basically that's it. Now, unlike RC3, there's a, by the way, when I was talking about the building over the entrance, it's so much easier in this game. Now I had to add a second lift hill there, as you saw it. This was the first roller coaster I ever built, by the way, so it's not the best, but I think it's good enough. It's alright. So, basically, what was I going to say? There's no height markers yet that I know about. I've tried searching how you turn them on, but I can't find anything, so I'm guessing they're not in the game. But I figured out a way how you can work out how high your roller coaster is from something else you've already done. And I'm just going to... Sorry about this, guys. There is a problem with... The screen's gone a bit neon here. It shouldn't have on your view, but for me, the edge is slightly cut off, so it's a bit harder to sort of... click on the exit the coaster pan button. So what I was saying is, there's no thing to height marker thinks you can toggle on and off like there was in RC2.3. I do hope they add that because to some people, if you don't know what to they are going to do, what I'm going to say now, like, they're not going to go know how high they are. Series basically. So what you do is it measures speed on liftings and stuff in meters per second, and this is only useful for lift hills, by the way, but they're usually at the highest point on a roller coaster anyway, so if you find out what the maximum height is, pretty much always get it accurate. The only trouble is with sort of roller coasters, you don't have any lift hills on them. Well, you could kind of do it, but not as well. Anyway, so it measures it in meters per second. So that's what you said. You can change the speed of the lift chain per second. And now, say the big one was, that's 65 meters high. It will often give the roller coasters, if you do find them out on the wiki and stuff, in feet, but it does often, it will often translate it into meters, and if not, you can. Search in Google, you can translate it anyway. So meters per second. So if you work it out, so say you've got to travel 65 meters and you're traveling at say 5 meters per second of speed. So it's gonna take 11 seconds because you're traveling at 5 meters per second meter. Get 65 meters high, so it's going to take 11 seconds. So what you can do is, if you know it's going to take 11 seconds going vertically up, then 45 degree gradient incline. Now this might sound a bit complicated, I know, but I'm just saying for the people who might be able to understand me how they can do this. So 45 is going to take twice as long because it's going to be going up like half as much per meter, so instead, so it's going to take 22 seconds, and then 30 meters, 30 degree incline because that's a third of 90, that's going to take 33 seconds. So if you know that, then you can pretty much, you just build, you can build it, build to how high you think, then you can time it, check if you got it high or low in, and then if you're too high, too low, you can just change it. And if you carry on trial and error, you should eventually get to the right height. So that's just a little bit there. So let's have a look at the other roller coasters. I kind of wanted to go and look at some other parks that people have built, but I might do that in a separate video, because this is definitely a series. I want you to know how amazing this is, so you can enjoy it, kind of. Which one? I'm trying to think which one I should go and ride next that I've built. I think I'm going to do the launch one now. I think that'd be a good one. Oh, actually, now we're here, let's go and do the Flawless Hamster. Now, this is one of the newer rides I've built. And I think it's one of the better as well. And we're about sorry. Kind of in the middle of it, but... And one unfortunate thing is that, unlike RCT 3, where you could, I'm trying to think now. Oh yeah, you could switch between coasters while in coaster cab. I don't know a way you can do this with this coaster cab. I will look into it and see if they're going to do the future, and maybe if you click on what does that arrow do? Oh, that's just change what seat you're in and stuff. Okay. Now, that's another thing. You can only have one train at the moment. So I think they might add more, I don't know, but I'm hoping that you do. And let's go and ride another one now, because we're going to run out of time otherwise. So which one shall I? I'll go for the. Shall I do the launch next? Oh, that's one I'm still working on. I might show you the building stuff later. Try and work on that. Now let's. I do want to ride this from the start. Because this is a good one. Now let's see where we are on the ride at the moment. This one, I do want, like I said, and I'll say it again, I do want to ride this from the start. Oh, this is the second launch. That, like RCT3, you can kind of do multi launches now. Now I will show you that in an episode, because well, it kind of is self-explanatory, kind of. There's a bit of logic involved to do it, but if you mess around, you can do it. So let's ride this from the start. So as you can see, we've got the first launch there. It's not the biggest launch in the world, but I wasn't that good at the game then, so I didn't really know what I was doing. And if you see them holes there from having tried and build vertical drop coaster, but it went a bit wrong. But that was when I was learning. That means now I know what I'm doing a bit more. I could probably do it. Anyway, we've launched. As you can see, into the first corner, and then we go down, a bit of air time, then we go around another banked corner. I do like this roller coaster. I've only ever ridden one launch coaster, actually. I want to do some more, but yeah, and we're into the second launch. if you look at these cars though, they're like the Stratocaster cars. There's only two of them in the world. Like, they look like the ones in R63, like racing car style. So it isn't the fastest launch coaster in the world, but I was kind of still messing around and stuff, so I didn't know properly what I was doing while I was building this. But there's more yet, guys. There's a good thing. I'm trying to think how many more coasters there are. There's definitely one more. Yeah, basically in this park, I've probably built a two ready roller coasters. That's because I was messing about with the different types, figuring out what would be best for what, basically. So pretty much just coaster after coaster after coaster, and then a couple of flat rides. Anyway. Oh, bad timing again. Oh, I think we're near the end though, I don't know. I couldn't have got the timing any worse, to be honest. Now this is fast, this ride, guys. And I'm going to show you from the start. The reason I didn't show that flawless coast from the start is because it's quite long and I don't have time to do it. Here we are then. And how many people are there waiting? Let me check. Oh, wrong side. How are they getting? Are we getting on? Oh, they just forgot to tell you they have the air gate stuff as well. You can tell they have worked hard in this. Here we go then. It's a big one, this one, guys. I think it could give Nemesis a run for its money at Alton Towers. Only joking. I don't think it's not that good. It's got four inversions, but not necessarily the best layout ever. Do with a couple more helixes or something, like they're often is on inverted ones. So we go down a big first drop, it's a very big drop that. Then there's a loop, then we come back up. And this bit's pretty slow. Go around the corner. Then we go into the bit that you just saw before. And then down. It is still quite smooth though, it's not too bad. Could be better, but I am quite happy with it. And then we go on to like the vertical corner at the end, and then into the brakes. And there we go. And that is, well, I can't actually say the name because we can't name him yet. That means it's just called coaster, whatever number it is I built in the park. I think that's the third one I built, that one. So, for how early I built it, it is quite good. I'm trying to figure out if there's any anything else I can show you. But, I think, have we done everything? Not sure we have. I'm sure we missed something. Oh yeah, now I remember we have. So this is a family coaster. It is quite forceful in some places, but and it's just coming back in perfect timing. It's not massive at all, really. I mean, it's not quite, I think it's more family coaster than a junior coaster. I think it's got more family coaster, so it's slightly, I'd say slightly scarier than a junior poster. But, yeah, still not the biggest thing. Compared to everything else, it's by far the smallest. I'd say I don't have any actual facts, but I think probably this, then the largest one for height. And then the tallest is that one over there that we went on. Is anyone... Oh, there we go. It doesn't make the noise when it sets off like Roller Coaster Tycoon, but in a way that's good because real rides don't really do that anyway. There we go. Then we go down the first drop. It does get a bit fast, this one, in places. That's why, main reason why I did call it a junior coaster is due to the speed. But you can see, nothing too bad. Slight banking on these corners. Now this is where it starts to get a bit more intense. But I think children, maybe not the first coaster, this one, but I think we could do it quite early on. And there we go. That is whatever that poster's called. Well, it doesn't have a name, of course. And there we go back into the station. So I think now, let me look how much time we've got left, we might be able to show you the flying coaster. But yeah, we've probably got a bit of time left, so I'm going to show you now something I'm working on. We're going to ride through it first, but then I'm going to show the building. And if you don't know what a flying coaster is, an example of one is Galactica at Old Town. I almost said air then, but then I remembered it's changed its name. And I've only ever ridden one flying coaster. And that was Hero at Flamingo Land, but never ridden one like this. This type's a bit different. So I'm going to set off. So as you can see, because it's a flying coaster, I think it'd be good that if it were like people's first flying coaster, trying to make it one that they could do as their first one. So I've not made it massive, as you can see. In fact, this could be smaller than the family coaster, I'm not sure. I reckon possibly it is. But anyway, we're at the top of the lift hill now. The good thing is in test mode, you can literally just jump on. You don't have to wait for it to get back to the station or anything. As you can see, going down the first drop, it's sharp, but it's small. And then we go around like a bank corner into sort of a lighter fly, but it's not the same as the one on air. Because it's still with a corkscrew instead of an inline twist. But yeah, what I want you... I want to show you this quickly before we go. We're not going to have time to show you any of the pre-made parts. And that's another thing, you can build your own stations. Yeah. There we go. So I'm going to show you how to build quickly. And, also, it's a chance for me to get a bit more of this ride done. So as you can see, there's that corner there. And you'll see that this track's much more flexible to play around with in RCT. So it does have angle snap, but you can turn that off. You need to change it to zero and just unclip it like that. But on zero, it still won't mess around with it. And then look at that, you can literally just drag the track in any way you want. So I'm going to drag this corner. I'm going to try. And I need to edit the bank room. It's we're in kind of a tricky situation here, actually. That's one problem with this system that I'd say is you can what I've done a few times get the banking slightly wrong, and then it kind of messes your ride up a bit. Well, not exactly, but yeah. And another thing is, I'm not sure if this is a glitch or what, it kind of does that for you, which isn't that good. And can we bring that down? Yeah, we can. There we go. There we go. Look at that. That's where we go. And then if we change the banking on that, so we can go like that. Well, we want it like that though, actually. So it's gonna come out, and then it's gonna sort of. I'm gonna bring it up a bit. That's gonna be sharp, but I have no other choice. So let me look. I want to do this kind of like an out and back layout on most wooden roller coasters. Speaking of wooden roller coasters, we haven't added them yet. I'm hoping we will, but. I did ask him on the, we sent him a message on Twitter asking if they were going to do that, but I've not heard anything back, so sorry about that, guys, I don't know for you. And have I missed a ride? What is, oh, that's just my flying coaster. So what I'm going to do then is I'm going to quickly. We've not got a lot of time left, but I do want to show you. That is going to be a bit intense, that section on the ride, but I have no choice. I'm going to be nice to my guests now and try and make it a bit windy. So it's going to sort of dive up. And then I'm going to bring it down and then around. Into. That is going to feel so good when you're on the ride as well, I think. And I'm hoping this isn't too high. So I'm going to place this bit of track. Does it make it? No. It doesn't make it. That's not too good, that. I'm going to have to sort it out later. Maybe edit the inversion or something. But, yeah, that's pretty much everything there is to see. The only other thing I could have showed you, like I said before, is those pre-made parks. But we don't. We've kind of run out of time, but we pretty much got through everything I wanted to go to there, so it's gone quite well. So that's the end of Game of the Week, Planet Coaster. Next week I'm not going to announce what it is, but what I will say is it's something that I've not done in a video before. I've played it, but I've not done it in a video. And something else I'll say, it's another game that's under development. So, that's in beta though. Anyway, thank you for watching, and I'll see you next week. Well, not next week, actually. Next week for this series, but there'll be a video online before then. I can promise that. Anyway, thank you for watching, and I'll see you all next.